Hello, Dominic from BMT Spain, and this video is first for Gopi from India, who asked me the difference between playing the forehand out of the arm and out of the hand. Now, it's also a video where you can see some differences in the forehand technique. Now, Gopi, I will start with the forehand out of the arm. If you watch the forehand of Del Potro, you will see that the hand and the racket all the time stays on the right side, and the moment he starts to go forward, you have that click here in that wrist and goes to contact. Now, we also had 20 years ago, Fernando Gonzalez, who had the fastest forehand and his time. So he also went out of the arm. The racket went even over the head, but he went down with the strings pointing to the fence. Then he turned the hand and went to contact. So these are two men with great forehand. So it's not because you have a forehand turning out of the arm that it will be bad. It will be a little more difficult for the timing. Now, this is also forehand you see more by the women. If you watch Barty, Halep, Gurgis, Svitolina, just to name four, if you watch them, the moment they start, the racket is already pointing to the left side, and the moment they come in the back, the racket is left, and they already have that slot position, and from there, they go to contact. Now, the one who is closest to Del Potro is Barty. She's not pointing that much to the left, so she has, the moment she starts forward, she has a little more room to use that hand movement. So, let's check it out on video. So, Barty, watch how the hand goes up and high over the shoulder. So, watch it here. The hand is high over the shoulder, so she's really turning out of the arm. And now, let's check out a little slower. This is Halep. Also here, she's turning out of the arm. Watch how the hand goes over that shoulder in the back. Now watch where the racket is already pointing. When the hand is in the back or behind the shoulder, it's already pointing to the left side. And let's check it from the side. Also here, watch how the hand goes over that shoulder. And when the hand is in the back, that racket is really pointing to the left side. It's not on the right side, and the angle does not change no more when she's going to contact. Then here we have Gurgis. Now this is very clear. Watch how high the hand is. The racket is pointing to the left side, so the angle does not change no more, and she goes in that way towards contact. We have the same with Svitolina. So here you have four top 10 players, yeah, turning out of the arm, and from there she goes, and the angle does not change no more. So here we have Fernando Gonzalez. 20 years ago, he was hitting the fastest forehand there are, 180 kilometers an hour. So turning out of the arm is not bad if you can have the timing. And here we have the Potro. Watch how his hand and his racket all the time stays on his right side. Even from the side view, it stays on the right side.
Now, we have seen the swings out of the arm. Now let's go out of the hand. This is more the modern forehand. So if you watch Federer, Nadal, Djokovic, Wawrinka, Dimitri, Tsitsipas, you name it, the difference is the body turn. So they turn the body and the elbow gets in that power position. So I show you from the side, they make that turn, the elbow comes in that power position, and from here they start to move the hand. Now you can move it, you can turn it. The professional way is more move first and then the turn. So you will see that from here on they will start to bring the hand backwards and then they start, or you can say the extension of the arm, but not everybody is extending. If you watch Federer, Federer has the extension, then the turn. If you watch Nadal, he starts to turn just before the extension, and by the turn he gets in that extension. Then if you watch, for instance, Kyrgios, Kyrgios will also turn, but he will never get into that extension. So you already see three differences just by bringing the hand back and the timing of when the hand motion turning out of the hand starts. Now, let's check out the videos.
So here we have Djokovic. Watch how they go to that power position. The elbow is in the back. The hand is on the right side, the racket is on the right side, even with the tip a little bit to the front. And here you can see the hand goes to the back, and there they start the turn of the hand. The side view going in that power position, the elbow is in the back, hand and racket on the right side, and here they start to turn.
The hand goes first to the back and then they turn. And then they go to contact. So here we have Dimitrov. Again, you see the power position, the elbow is in the back, hand and racket on the right side, the tip a little bit pointing to the front, and the hand goes back and in the back. Yeah, this is where the turn of the hand, the wrist action happens. Again here, hand goes to the back, and here he starts to turn. So this is the part that we will see with most of them, but now let's check out the extension part and when they start to turn. So here we see Federer. So Federer gets in that extension before he starts to turn. And from there on, he will go to that contact point. And then we have here, we have Nadal. So as you can see, Nadal will start to turn before he gets in extension now. And he turns actually into that extension. Nadal has also more shoulder and hip turn. This is also a small difference we will see. Now let's go to Tsitsipas, who turns the most out of the hand. So here we have him. His arm is not extended yet, but watch his shoulder line. Watch where his racket is. And there is almost no shoulder and hip, but he turned that racket literally in that position. And from here, yeah, he will go to the contact and pull the racket over that shoulder. Now here you can see he turns out of that hand, and from there he goes to its contact. So here we have the Potro again, and watch how the hand, just before he goes in that forward action, the hand turns in that slot position, and from there he goes to that contact.
So you have seen the videos. Now my way of starting is start to learn to turn out of the hand first, because afterwards it's easier to get with the hand and then turn. So I mean is that in that same position I can start to turn my hand and make my stroke. The advantage we have with that is that if you turn out of your hand, your arm is relaxed, and most people, if they squeeze too hard, it's hard to turn out of the hand. So by turning out of the hand, you are more relaxed. The second advantage you have is that you can turn short or you can turn big. So if the ball is further away, you have more time. You can turn from that position. You can turn the racket there and go to your ball. Now, if the ball is shorter or faster, you can from that position turn also here and play the ball. So a short turn or faster turn or a longer turn and a slower turn is another advantage you have. Once you have a better rhythm and you learn to take the ball faster, you already get used to that. Your hand is closer to the ball and you can turn directly from here, taking that ball faster. It's also something you will use by the return. You go here and from here you start to turn out of the hand. So you don't have to go back every time completely and then come back. That's another advantage. So by starting to turn out of the hand, later on, it's easier to adjust. If you have more time and you go first and then you turn, it's no problem. So I will play a few balls. So let's check out my hand movement. Let's check this out. Now I'm going to turn to my power position and I will turn directly out of my hand. These balls normally will be slower and I will have more time. So as you can see, my racket starts to turn directly. It's not that I have a lot of speed. Now these balls will come faster or will come deeper. So as you could see, I did miss one ball. I was waiting for that bounce and then I turned the racket straight out of my hand. So we also train the more professional way. So now I will go first with my hand back before I turn the racket. I go back and then I turn. So my hand goes back and then I turn. So the hand goes back and then I turn. So these are two different ways to turn the racket. Now, if the ball comes deeper and faster, the second way, I have to adjust a little more. So again, I go back. Yeah, I go back. So as you could see, this one was already a little more difficult. So if I turn directly from that position, deep ball, if I turn directly from this position, I have more time because I stay shorter. So I'll turn directly out of the hand, or the hand goes first to the back and then you turn. It's the same if you have higher contacts and you can stay shorter, higher contacts. So if you're here, you turn, and that's a nice deep ball. Hands are higher and you turn. You can also high, go back and then turn. So the hands are higher, they go back and then you turn. So it doesn't matter with ball comes, you can use both, but for relaxation, for me, it's better that you start first to turn out of the hand. So there you could see the differences by starting directly out of your hand or first bringing the hand. Once you have this going to that, it's easy, but you start in a relaxed position. So Gopi, I hope this helped you more to understand the difference between the arm and the hand. And all I can say is thank you for watching. See you in the next video.
So if you're interested in playing college tennis and get a tennis scholarship, do not hesitate to contact the Koa Sports. His founder, Raymond Govest, can help you to find the best university where you can keep playing your favorite sport and be granted with a scholarship that can cover up to 100% of your college cost, including everything, tuition, room and board, books, insurance, and so on. They have been assisting international tennis players for more than 18 years. Feel free to email them at rcoves@decoasports.com, and for further information, check www.decoasports.com. So again, thank you for watching. See you in another video.